YouTube, my name is Evan, and in today's video, I'm going to be doing a video about what I feed my guinea pigs. And first, I just want to say two things. I am not going to pretend like I know all of the vitamins and everything that's in these vegetables. I'm going to say what I do know, but I'm not going to pretend like I know everything. I would point you to Saskia from LA Guinea Pig Rescue. That's actually where I got this idea to have Lionel with me in this video. Also because I didn't just want, you know, my face talking about lettuce for too long. I feel like that's kind of weird. So I'm just going to get right into it. Okay, so right now I have Lionel with me. Lionel loves vegetables, as do all guinea pigs. And so here are a few of the things that I give them. So first off, pellets, of course. What I do is I get oxbow pellets. I get them from Chewy online because I'm able to get a 25-pound box, or bag, I mean. And in my, as far as I've seen, that is the cheapest that I could get. So that's what I get for the food. And so what I do is I have these bowls from the LA Guinea Pig Rescue. These are really cute. They don't spill or anything like that. And I have three piggies. I fill two of these each day in the morning. And they usually finish it or they're almost done in the nighttime. And that's when I give them vegetables. I try not to fill this too much. I have seen like differing opinions online. Like some always want it to be available. Some say to not have too much. So my middle ground has been putting one scoop of like food into each. And that has been fine for me. Lionel. The next thing I want to show you is pea flakes, and this is just the guinea pig's absolute favorite thing. This is a great bonding tool, I would say. Like, try to give them one in your hand and then pet them a little. This is just, I mean, I have no words to say. This is their favorite thing, right, Lionel? Nom 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 nom. Sometimes I do this. Shh. I really don't do that too much. Okay, so now we're gonna go on to the vegetables. The first thing, the main thing that I give them is lettuce. And guinea pigs just like, oh my god, this is like their favorite thing ever. I mean, it's like, I don't have an analogy, but it is so great. See, Lionel just is like, he's been waiting for this the whole time. Here you go, Lionel. Oh, he's trying to hide. This is so funny. Like, if you have guinea pigs, you know this. When you give them a vegetable, a fruit, or something like that, which you shouldn't give them fruit too much, but if you do, they'll like back up and like try to find somewhere to eat it. Especially if they're like with other guinea pigs, you know, they'll go into a house and be like, oh my god, someone's there, and like go into another house, and it's just so funny to watch them sometimes. Next we're gonna show dandelions, and this is something I have not given the guinea pigs in a long time, to be honest. I used to find these at my house in the backyard, and I think any yard, like, they just grow. When people talk about like weeds in their yard, they're usually dandelions. And so if you do have a yard, I would definitely recommend looking out for them. I'm going to try to include some pictures on screen showing what they look like. But I found this dandelion, and of course it was cut and everything, from a Korean market. I haven't found it at, like, you know, Walmart or anything like that. And they love dandelion, especially the fact that you can find this in your garden. See, right now he's eating the dandelion instead. The fact you could find this in the garden means you could probably get it for free for your guinea pigs. And I've seen it in the store, at Petco or somewhere else, where they sell it as, like, you know, dried wild forage. And I'm like, I could find this in my backyard. I don't need to buy this. And when I did go to the Korean market, this is actually pretty cheap. And this whole big bag of dandelions, it's like these really long strings. And when they're in the wild, I think, you know those things where you, like, you blow and make a wish and they have like those little fuzzies on top? That's the dandelions. And so you can pull off the leaves, even sometimes the stem. I found if the stem is like a little dirty or if it's a little dry, they won't eat it. But I've seen them definitely eat the stem. So pull out the seeds before you give it to them. But dandelions is a great option to feed guinea pigs. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to show you is parsley. And I feel like I keep saying this, but this is one of their favorite things ever. I'm going to include some video on screen, but like, they love this. And see, here's parsley, and Lionel just wants it. Ooh, get up, Lionel. Guinea pigs love parsley. Cilantro is also fine, but this is something I give more of a snack. After I go over like each of these vegetables, I'll show like the proportion I tend to give. I'll be honest, I tend to give a lot to my guinea pigs. I was watching some videos and they were like, oh, give this much per guinea pig. I was like, oh my God. I definitely give a lot to my guinea pigs, and I they know when to stop, I feel like. They know when to like not eat too much. So I trust their judgment and how much to eat. But yeah, parsley, cilantro is just great for guinea pigs. They love it. The next thing I'm going to show is carrots. And right now I have these cut up. So what I did is, if you go to the store and you have like organic carrots there, you'll notice those are the ones with like the leaves sticking out. And I would get those because they could eat the leaves. And so that's what I did here. Like, you don't see it because I already gave it to them, but I cut off the leaf, the roots or the grass, whatever, I don't know what to call it, the end of a carrot separately. And that just is like a whole nother snack, you know? But carrots, I found that like my other two guinea pigs love carrots, and Lionel doesn't really care too much for carrots. Right now he's like looking for something else to eat. Oh, there he goes. There you go, Lionel. Next thing I'm gonna show is tomatoes. And these are the ones I like to get, these little cherry tomatoes, because they're small for guinea pigs to eat. And this is something, because they're so small, I could just get one per guinea pig. And see, this is like, he loves it. Look, he's gonna stand up. Ooh, go Lionel. I like to give one of these per day. This is something I give them when I'm going into the kitchen and they think I'm gonna give them something, and I'm like, no, I'm just getting something for me, and I'm like, I feel bad, so I give them something. I tend to grab one of these little cherry tomatoes. You know what? I would say for the cherry tomatoes, it's up to you if you want to cut them or not. Like, they are already pretty small, but I've noticed sometimes the guinea pig, like, they push them to the side because it's hard to get their teeth into it. So if that is the case, oh, Lionel, no, not from there. Okay, Lionel. Anyways, like I was saying, I think this is a fine size to give to the guinea pigs. I mean, it takes them like a minute maybe, but they're able to bite into it and start eating it. If you would like to, you can cut it in half. That's also a good way to like split it between your guinea pigs, maybe save on them a little bit. I just like to get one and just give them to the guinea pig. So the next and last vegetable I wanted to show was bell peppers. And the reason it's the last one I'm showing is because my guinea pigs don't really like bell peppers. This is the one thing that tends to stay in the cage the longest. And they'll eat it when there's nothing else. They're like, oh, fine, I'll eat the bell pepper. But I've heard they're really good. I got these little sweet peppers because they're smaller, and I just crack them, like break them in half, and then I put them in the cage. So now that I talked about all the vegetables, just to go over a little bit the proportion, the amount that I give them, and how I feed them, I put everything on this sheet, and I basically just fill it up with like a mound of vegetables. And I know that might seem like a lot, but I mean, my guinea pigs are able to like stop themselves. I trust them to not kill themselves with eating too much vegetables. So that's what I do. I tend to give it to them once a day, like a whole plate of vegetables. And I just grab each of this stuff and I just put it there. I mean, the lettuce, the parsley, I do kind of break it in half or three pieces, but I tend not to spend too much time. I definitely don't get a cutting board and like, you know, cut everything like a chef, you know, and put it there. I used to do that. When my guinea pigs were little, I really didn't give that much. I gave maybe like two of these bowls filled with vegetables. So now that my guinea pigs are older, I just like throw everything on there and put it there. Yeah, I think it's fine. The guinea pigs know when to stop themselves. If you are thinking of giving your guinea pig something and you're not sure, I would recommend two things. Number one, if you could eat it, they could probably eat it. So just like, you know, be smart, I guess. I mean, I hate to say that, but like you could probably tell, like, you know, hey, is this actually like I should be feeding the guinea pig? I think you should be able to tell. And second of all, like it's probably fine in moderation. I mean, especially like with fruit, you don't want to give too much, but this is the same kind of like thinking and like, you know, reasoning you would apply to yourself in your own diet. So just be like conscious of what you're feeding them. I mean, you're probably caring more about what you feed them than what you feed yourself. I mean, that's just fact, at least for me. Things that are not here that I have fed them, but not too much, broccoli, I tend to just give them the stems and I cut it up in little pieces, and I really don't give them that too much, maybe like once a week. Another thing is kale. I don't give them too much because I heard the calcium content is bad. Spinach, that's not something I give them sometimes. I just don't give them spinach because I heard that's bad as well. And see, like everything is I hear it's bad. Also iceberg lettuce. I did mention lettuce. I never get iceberg lettuce because that's just water. It's not like bad for them or anything. It's not poisonous. I don't know why I see that people think it's poisonous apparently. And I'm like, what? It's not poisonous. It's just water. And I think the same for myself. Like I don't eat it because it's just water. I'd rather give them like green leaf lettuce, red leaf lettuce, or romaine lettuce. Those are the ones I tend to get for them. And then also you can give them certain like leftover remains. So going off of that, strawberries, radish, watermelon, that's something else I've given them. So when you cut out the red from a watermelon, the green part, and they actually look like they like the skin more than they like the sugary red part. But because it's sugar, I would like not give too much of that. So that is it for my video. Thank you so much for watching it until the end. I hope you learned something, and just a reminder that guinea pig, feeding them vegetables and stuff is a great bonding opportunity. So if your guinea pigs are new or if they're shy with you, try to hand feed them, pet them at the same time, and hopefully they'll get accustomed to you a little faster. But that's going to be it from me. Make sure that you subscribe, like the video, hit the bell icon so that you don't miss more videos from me. And I am going to post like a big update next week regarding a second channel, but this one is going to stay with guinea pig content. So yeah, I'll see you all next week. Bye!